There is only one thing most important that remember, and is not to forget. So that's my point of view. In this moment, more than ever in Europe, while racism, hate, ignorance and anti-Semitism are raising again all over Europe, I had the opportunity and the pleasure to document the last speech for Liliana Segre. Every one of these last living survivors has been very committed to having lessons with young people to tell their stories. That morning it was a pleasure because we talked for a long time of the darkest side of his life, but after just a few minutes we were laughing and eating together, celebrating daily life. In the camp, Terracina befriended another young Italian deportee, Sami Modiano, from Rhodes in Greece, only 2 years younger than him. Remembered by Modiano as a true, deep fraternal friendship. Let them struggle for life together, so one could help the other. So they managed together to stay alive. So their friendship saved together, both of them. One day, after Piero Terracina started to testify his experience in the 80s, Sami was watching the TV, so he recognized him. And they got in contact again a very long time after their last days together. It was a very an emotional feeling for them. He said, "We wonder what will happen to the memory of Shoah when the last survivor will disappear. His children will be here to continue to testify. And this is the motto of the Son of Shoah Association in Milan. I hope after the COVID emergency, I could be able to meet the last living survivors, speak with them, hear them, and taking pictures to complete as much as I can this little part of my little project. It's just a drop in the ocean, but I feel like it's important the same.